dad's side. I haven't seen him on my dad's side forever. Chillo!
Yeah.
DJ Big Dollar with my man, Chef Yancey. And we are here, and I'm glad you're here. Welcome to the Big Dollar Show. Today's topic is very simple. It's important. The importance of fitness. Let me get to my notes. It's not, it should be obvious, to be honest with you at this point. But a lot of people, look, I don't think fat people can be very good. I just don't see it. I think most of our problems come from, diet and shit. I can't think of one fat person where I was like, I like any of those. No, I don't like any of those. I'm a skinny guy. It's hard for me to gain weight. I was like 150 until 24, 25, 29 now. And I started becoming a bodybuilder.
That's true, sir. I'm not going to demonize fat people or anything like that, but I'm just saying, you see a lot of old people, you see a lot of fat people. You don't see a lot of old fat people.
No, you don't, because it's too much weight to carry. To me, I think it clogs the mind.
That being said, body size is not really a choice. You're kind of blown with the genetics you got. Eating everything you want all the time you want it definitely shouldn't be a thing.
Oh, man. There's a time where, now we get to choose what we're going to eat. When we were kids, we couldn't even choose what we wanted to eat. Like, whatever we could afford is what you can get.
Yeah.
That's it.
You're just eating McDonald's and a couple Snickers for dinner. That's
pretty much it, I guess it works both ways. It could be unhealthy, it's unhealthy. But think about, our grandparents, maybe. Did your mom and dad live through the Great Depression?
No, they nearly missed it.
Was it the 20s, the Great Depression?
No, it was in the 1930s.
1930s, because the 20s was the roaring 20s. It was a big boom, right? So, man, think about going in to eat potatoes and, water that you can find it.
I do love potatoes.
I love potatoes.
Great Depression was sick, but it was worse for black people. Because black people already couldn't find jobs, so the jobs they couldn't find were...
Mike. Don't forget about the man.
Yeah, the jobs they couldn't find were exacerbated because I can't hire white people, why would I hire a black person?
Why would black ass. Get your black ass around there.
So physical fitness kind of seems nowadays like it's a privilege. It's one of those things that only the elite can have, or... I was looking at a thing a couple days ago that says the average size of a person is plus size. Like we're American. The average size of an American is a plus size person.
The obesity rate in America is 41.9% of adults.
So the average person,
there's more. Black adults had the highest level of adult obesity at 49.9. And then Hispanics are at 45.6. And then whites are at 41.4.
I had the privilege of being in Mexico City maybe 4 or 6 months ago. And I noticed that they look like us New Orleans. Like, we're not skinny.
We're thick as fuck.
Yeah, they
only eat seafood. It was like, man, that's a lot of seafood.
And one medicine guy made a trip there. He's like, well, we have the vitamin T's here that keep us like this. We have tacos, tequila, taquitos. But and like I said, it's not their fault. It's just the way society works. We know they're going to buy the cheapest shit that has the highest profit margin, so why not put tacos, taquitos, tequila in their neighborhoods?
I know you're not a fan of Joe Rogan, but he said something so interesting. He's like, all that shit in the middle of the grocery store is not really the healthy shit. It's all that shit on the outside, and then like along the walls. And I thought about it, he was exactly right. Like, all that stuff in the middle is basically the sales. It's not really, and that's so much more stuff than the stuff around the walls, if you think about it. It is more expensive, not the meat. Meat's pretty expensive right now.
It's crazy.
What's going on with that? I guess that's the environmentalist. I'm not with the environmentalist right now. I guess I'm always going to do that shit. The idea of throwing shit on painting and stuff like that. Why? Because it's an oil painting? You think that's going to stop?
No, it's just brings awareness.
It does bring awareness. When you're sitting in the middle of the street and shit, I've seen some wild videos. People laying in the street and saying, stop oil. It's like, no. You know that the places that don't eat meat, like the countries that don't eat meat, have the worst growth in children? that's, come on, that's telling you something. Like, it's not.
Yeah, I'm not saying it's not a thing, but I'm saying that we're smarter to figure out a way around it. You ever heard the story of a mom who carried a child, I don't know, I want to say it was like 300 miles, but they died?
300 miles.
300 miles.
I don't know about you guys, but them damn scam like this stuff.
Yeah, there's a mom, she carried a child 300 miles, and it's on camera. Because the child died, and she's in mourning, didn't know what else to do with it. And that's a whale. That's not a human, that's a whale. Like, animals have feelings, emotions, they have thoughts.
Oh, a whale carried?
Yes, sir. It was a whale.
Whales eat meat.
Yeah, they do.
How about that? Vegetarians. I don't have a problem with you, you know, eating what you want to eat either.
I'm saying that we're humans, and we're the smartest things that ever existed,
yeah,
to our knowledge. Sure. And there should be a way around it. We shouldn't have to, like, cause suffering and murder in order to live. I remember back in the day when we thought the only way to get cotton was to hit somebody in the back with a leather whip and make them get cotton faster.
That was a thing?
That's
it.
But
is a white guy thing? Yeah. I never heard of that. Sounds like something white people do. Which isn't true. Obviously, slavery is not a bonus.
Yeah.
You know.
And they was like, there's no way around it. We just need this thing. It was like, we can't stop it. We're doing it. We've been doing it for so long. There's no way we can stop doing this. And it causes cruelty to a person that we think of as less than deserving empathy. And I'm not saying you should stop eating meat. We should probably stop eating meat. I'm not. But you should.
Yeah, you should stop.
Yeah, y'all should stop.
Don't expect me to. That's how these are.
I got some steaks in the freezer and they are fucking awesome.
Oh my god.
But your children, do not grow your children up eating meat because it's fucking delicious. This is my theory I have.
What's your theory, bro?
You know how you don't eat pork? Like, you're not supposed to eat pork if you're like Muslim or Jewish or anything like that?
Because
I feel like maybe, and this is a very stupid theory, no one takes it seriously. Pigs were human.
Pigs were human?
Pigs were a subspecies of humans. And it's like, you get over here in these cages and they devolved. And it's like, all right, guys, these guys were human, but you know what? They evolved. We should not eat them because they were human. They're fucking right. Delicious.
All right. Yeah, it was stupid.
I know. It is very stupid. This is stupid. Let me continue.
Pigs are good because they were slavers. That's all they gave us to eat.
Yeah.
I don't think they were human.
Yeah, pigs were human. And that's why so many religions and so many cultures are like, don't eat pigs.
I just think they think that they're dirty. It's like they're too good for it. Like shrimp. People are like, oh, the sea cockroach.
Yeah, somebody told me that Asians don't like catfish.
Yes, my grandma didn't really eat catfish. That's my favorite fish. But to stay on point.
Who's my favorite food? Is it a food? Yeah, I'll eat it.
Damn, dude. I don't know what to say about that. I do try to try new stuff, but I gotta tell you, I stick to my guns. I don't deviate.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever eaten?
Nothing really weird, you know, just calamari and shit. I think when I started traveling though, I was like,
you had turtle, right?
I had the alligator. I did have turtle.
Yeah. Now, see, your definition of weird is not weird because you're from here.
Right.
You're from Louisiana. The weirdest thing I've eaten jellied eels.
Jellied eels?
Jellied eels.
Jellied eels.
So somebody put, you know what Jell-O is like, right?
Yeah.
So imagine Jell-O without any flavor. And somebody put eels in it. And you know what they flavored it with? I'll give you a hint. Nothing.
So it just tastes like jelly eel.
It tastes like jelly eel, yeah.
Who did this? Who made this?
Luckily, there was saltine crackers to go with.
That doesn't make you feel
good. No, it didn't. I don't think they even had saltine crackers. It was pretty bad.
See, I guess getting two pieces of starch and said it was gross with it. I love calamari.
No, it did not taste like calamari. It tastes like Jell-O, with no Jell-O, eels, with no flavor, but slimy. It was great.
You keep going. Where did you eat this?
London. This is a delicacy in London, apparently. Or, not delicacy, like it's a thing you can only get in London.
That's a weird thing to be. But to get back on, you know, the fitness, let's get back on the fitness. What's that say? It says regular physical activity is one of the most important things you can do for your health. Being physically active can improve your brain health, help manage weight, reduce the risk of disease, strengthen bones and muscles, improve your ability to do whatever the activities. That's basically what we just said. Let's see the comments over here.
Yeah, I was reading that, even if you do a 20-minute walk a day, it just pushes back diseases and all that stuff like that. So the real argument is why why is it more encouraged? Why? Because everyone has like some kind of medical health insurance. Not everyone. Obviously, I mean, a good part of the country is like, I think we're like 60% insured now. Why isn't that like almost mandatory? Because the benefits are so overwhelmingly positive. Like everyone, in the middle of your work day, you should go out and do some jumping jacks or some shit, or take a walk, or free gym membership.
I think that goes into the whole mind control that they have. You know that they want people in, they want weak people so they can tell them what to do. Well, here we go. Health insurance coverage in the U.S. In 2021, 35.7% of people held public coverage for some or all of them, making a 1.2% increase from 2020. So only 35.
Oh, shit.
Less than 40.
That's not me, dude. I feel it's a lot higher than
I thought it was like 80 because we have free health care right now. Right?
Ish. Free-ish.
It's free-ish. I know you can have Medicare in this state at least.
There's still a lot of hoops, so that's why I assume it was 60, because like you still gotta do something. It's not like just given to you. You can't just go to a hospital, but it's free.
I do think, because again, if I'm saying, I think fat people don't think straight, bro. I don't think that their mind is all the way. Because think about how clogged your arteries can be, think about how much blood your brain needs and how it has to get oxygenated and all that stuff. That fat clogs, bro. It's gonna get in the way. I'm not 100% sure, but you're thinking, okay, you know.
And this is one of the things I want to say. I'm not trying to demonize fat people.
You're not about demonizing.
But I was reading this thing, and it's like, you shouldn't shy away from the word fat, because it's not like a shame thing.
What is that about? Where did that come from? If you're fucking fat, you're fat.
Yes,
I'm not afraid of you for being fat.
No,
fat.
A lot of people like put shame on words like that. Like, a lot of people don't like saying the word black. It's like, nigga, I am black. It's like, I'm black. It's like, they don't say the word skinny. Like, yeah, they don't say like the thing, which makes it even worse, you know? I feel like whenever you don't call, for better words, a spade, it's kind of worse. You know?
It gets way
like
worse.
Like when you jump around it, it's like, oh, you're chunky, you're thick, you know?
You're fucking fat. Alright, and assuming you're accepted, assuming you can do something.
No, I mean, not even do something about it, it's like, just don't die.
You don't have to.
He's not supposed to die.
I'm not saying you have to do anything about it, but you have to accept it before you can do anything. You know, you're not gonna, we live in a weird time, bro.
It's so good.
It's
we're living in the greatest time. I'm sorry, you're continuing.
You are good. I mean, because you're right. It is the greatest time that probably ever was. But I guess it's not too many opinions or like opinions. Too many people are sure of what they think. That makes sense. Like, how are you so fucking sure that I'm a fat fool or a trans fool from me saying, like, I don't have to like that you're gay. And I'm not saying I don't like gay people. I don't have to like you at all. That's life. I don't have to, you know, even associate with you.
Yeah.
Why the fuck
would I like, I don't like you. He's like, oh, you like me gay? He's like, no, I just don't like you. Like you.
And if, what
I
if
not
I,
like you.
What if I don't like you because you're gay? I'm not making the fucking laws. I'm not the person standing in front of you and I don't even know where you're getting logged from these things. But I'm not stopping your forward progress. What if I do have a problem? Because there's certain attitudes that are associated with gay people, like loud and obnoxious, which are associated with everybody. But it's like, the gay
not everybody. Time.
No, white people can be loud and obnoxious.
No, it's not associated with them. Loud and obnoxious is only associated with
black people.
Gay people, black women. That's it.
Yes,
black men are aggressive and dangerous. So if a black man is loud and obnoxious, they're dangerous and they need to be handled. Black women and gay people in general are loud and obnoxious and they're just like fucking annoying. White people are just white people.
I think again, because we live in a predominantly white society, black people think white people are pieces of shit. I'm not joking. Like Asian people, I guess I have more respect than this, but I can't say 100% that every other group doesn't think that white people are fucking, you know. I can't think of any white guys being labeled as that, though.
I feel somewhat privileged. Like, I grew up in both societies, I guess. I grew up in New Orleans, for the most part. I lived with black people, around black people. I remember there was only, like, three white people in our school.
Mm-hmm.
And we go to Black History Month, and teach about, like, segregation and slavery. We all look at two white people. But also, I remember the other side. Like, I remember being in high school, and it'd be predominantly a white high school, and they'd be like, segregation, and they'd be like, yeah, so you want to tell us about this? Like, Hey, I'm 15.
I had a similar, you know, grew up here, all black elementary, Katrina Hill in Houston, bunch of all white people, you know, but Atlanta is half white. I look like a good school in Atlanta, half white, half black, which is 84 there, black university. And you know, some of my closest friends are going to be.
You was
in
Xavier?
I went to Xavier.
I didn't get it. My mom was in Xavier.
I'm cool with it if you're a woman, but if you're a man, I feel like it's based. It's like I couldn't find one male role model there. I was like, I'm following you to the promised land. You're going to teach me how to be a man, which is what made me end up leaving. And you know how everything's skewed towards women, so I was like, I couldn't function there very well. There's nothing wrong. It was an awesome girls' school before, wasn't it? Captain Drexel, I think it was.
Not the university.
Just the, what was that? Was it a charter school?
Yeah, a charter school was, yeah.
So, again, I don't mind. And here's another thing. I'm not a fucking misogynist just because I don't cater to every feeling no one has. I can't even figure out the emotions you're going through. I got this thing where, this thing happens to me, but I'm supposed to, what's the word? I keep saying cater.
Empathize.
It's not empathy, because I also understand their struggles. People go through things all the time. But I'm not responsible for your self-esteem. I'm not responsible. Like, I don't have to fuck with you. When I don't take it as I'm being mean. If I do, don't take it as I'm just some fucking, you know, pervert or some shit. I'm just saying that, like, man, woman left her keys on the counter, walking up to maybe it's a gas station or something. You say, hey, your keys. She, you know, grabs them. And it's not a problem with black too.
Yeah, that happens a lot.
But it's like, oh, I know this guy was like, no, I'm not. You left your keys.
One of my favorite things is, I walk by a car because I'm black.
No, it wasn't her, like, clutching her purse or nothing. Yeah. It was more like, oh, he's talking, let me hurry up. Pretend like I don't hear him. You know what I'm saying? Like, because she never saw me. She just knew I was a guy behind her. She never looked at me or anything. You know, I don't necessarily speak rap or whatever, but I speak pretty well. It happened again. I was dropping off an Uber. I go to the door here, the bar's at the corner. Here you are, blah, 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 and this. And I need a pin from him in this particular delivery so I can confirm it. And some people, you know, they're afraid their food gets stolen and blah, blah, blah. So you have to put in the pin that they have, blah, blah, blah. I ask her for it, and she's like, oh, no, I don't. And maybe that one was, because she saw me in my face. But even with that, it's like, nobody's after you. It's in your fucking head. And I'm not going to be responsible for your fucking delusions. I literally pulled off and texted her from the app. Because I'm like, I'm not waiting my door. I'm not going to ask her again. I'm not going to accept the way they react. Like, I'm not. If you have a fear, especially if you have a fear that's not something you didn't experience, I'm not responsible for you. I don't. And it's mostly factual for me. It's like overweight black women or just the fat white girl that's a part of black culture or feels like she's a part of black culture. I'm not here for you. I'm not here to. I don't know what it is. I can't think of what it is. Like, I know everybody is trying to fuck you, but I'm not. I'm just trying to either tell you love something, tell you something that had nothing to do with sex or any type of attraction thing. They're just telling you something you need to know for your benefit, because I don't need to talk to you. And that's it. I'm walking away. I'm going to forget about you. I'm tired of it, bro. What is that going on? I think it's a little obesity, though. I think a bunch of people out of shape that just not thinking right. I think, have you seen some of our guys around here super skinny? Like, they look malnourished to me. You ever seen a super skinny black dude that's like, man, do you do any push-ups? Do you even eat? Do you do this? Do you do that? I see them all the time. They're always young.
But young people are definitely skinnier than older people. Like, you get the old man strength, you know, as I said.
I think you're malnourished, dog. I don't think, you know, I guess it's the opposite side of fitness. No, that's in fitness, right? Even being too skinny is not in shape. So, I don't get it. I know when I was skinny, I was like, I need to eat, bro. I need to work out, because I don't like how skinny I am. And I gotta tell you, I've been doing pretty well since I've been working out and shit. I feel good.
It helps your brain chemistry, makes you feel more relaxed, it makes you all focus.
Anxiety, it does, yeah. But why don't people want to do it? Is it that they're afraid? It's too much work?
Everything's cultural. Like, if there's a cultural need for us to all work out, well, look at TV, everyone looks flawlessly awesome all the time.
They work out.
Yeah. But they don't show that. You don't see the effort, you just see them flawlessly awesome, sitting around with your legs cocked up drinking martinis.
That's probably where this fat phobia shit is coming from. Like, you think you're normal? You think you would have survived, you know, 100, 200 years ago as a fat person? They picked the lion, pick you out. They're coming for you, fat. You're not going to survive. You're not going to survive. There's not even enough food to sustain that state of human being. I'm not talking about Greece, where a thicker woman was, you know. I'm not talking about where the Saudi Arabia, where fatter women being taken care of. I'm talking about your fat ass eating too much and not, and thinking that's all right. But I don't want to see, man, I'm not going to see it. So I take that back. But I don't want to get into a discussion about me being afraid of fat people, because I say that being fat is unhealthy. And that's where we're at. I don't get it. And maybe they're just talking shit on their social media, but it's a shame where we are to me. It's such a shame. I don't know why what's that guy do? There's a guy in the White House. He's like he dresses up in the BDSM stuff. He's transgender. He wears his dresses and stuff. Don't remember his name.
Bob Ross.
Is that him?
It's only the right person you want to
know. Bob Ross?
Yeah.
You're talking about the painter?
Yeah, that's it.
Sorry. I'm going to look it up. No, I'm not sure. There's a guy, dog. And how do you feel about these Biden documents coming up? They find this shit all over the place in Biden, dude.
Yeah, that's what makes me wonder. Like, every president just keeps all that shit we're done. It's like, well, I guess these are mine now.
I'm almost certain. That's why I'm, you know, I keep saying they're all the same people. They're only picking on Trump because he's not a part of the group.
And he's a piece of shit.
Well, yeah, he probably is a piece of shit. I don't know what this guy's name is. Anyway, I don't know his name, but I knew it a while ago. But he's the guy that...
Ooh, next week. Hot take.
What?
I'm going to give you all the reasons I'm glad Reagan is dead. And by Reagan, I mean Ronald Reagan. to the backdrop of... Nice shot, man.
Nice shot, man.
Because he was almost assassinated.
He missed.
Yeah, sad day.
Terrible.
Sad day of history.
You really don't like this guy.
Oh, yeah.
Have you been working out?
Not as much as I should be.
See? Ooh, you become a psychopath.
This chance to push up. But yeah, my gym kind of kicked me out.
You told me about that. What happened?
Dude, they wanted me to come in and sign a thing. I was like, dude, I get off work at 2 a.m. There's no one there. I was like, I'm going to work at like 9-ish. No one there. I was like, well, you can't charge me if I'm not there. And they stopped charging me for the last couple months. I was like, well, I guess I'm out of my gym membership.
Oh, I thought they were still charging
you. No.
What was it
about? No, it was. They charged me a late fee. Not because it lasts, I was still going. However, I couldn't sign a new thing and charge me like an extra, $70? I was like, whoa. I told him to email me. I was like, look, I don't care about paying. I was like, I'll pay. He emailed me. He's like, but I didn't want to pay the late fee. So I have to go IRL and talk to him, but I don't think they charged me. I'm going through my statement again. Well, yeah, I blasted him on the social media thing. I blasted him on Yelp and Google.
Is this anytime?
Yeah, Anytime Fitness. Anytime Fitness is, it's not a scam. They're fine. It's a little scammy. Like, once you give them your information, they'll charge you for the rest of your entire life.
That's not Blender Fitness. They're still trying to charge you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, you know, that's why you're asking my account number and shit. Because you motherfuckers will not stop charging me.
Yeah, but Anytime, if you go to Anytime, you go to Anytime anywhere. Like, I've been to Anytime in Mexico. I've been to Anytime in London, Texas. I've been to Anytime in Chicago. Like, there, I just get, a workout in when I'm there, out of town. So if I'm out of town for a week, at least I'm not, like, losing the whole routine. But if I started going to the one on the other side of town instead of the south side of town. It's like, oh, well, you switch gyms, you gotta, like, breathe, do your thing. It's like, motherfucker, I've been everywhere in the world at any time. It's like, why do I gotta change anything? He's like, well, you gotta. It's like, that doesn't make any fucking sense. He's like, oh, and also you have a late fee. And I was like, well, I'm not paying that at all. Also, I did pay the late fee. I went there, IRL, and gave him my card and paid it. He's like, no, sorry, you gotta pay another fee and do a new contract. I was like, I'm just not doing that. So I guess fuck Anytime Fitness, I'm gonna find a new place to work out.
Not to cut you off, man, but this fucking guy right here. This guy that was stealing stuff from the fucking airport.
What's this?
What's his name?
Ooh, let's do a segment. Let's do just in.
Nine by there. That's me.
So let's cut to a segment that we just had. It's called Just Saying.
Okay, you know what? Yeah, just saying. This fucking guy here, Sam Brinton, is 35. He's a Biden official. He was stealing fucking luggage.
Pause for a minute.
I'm not gonna pause. I'm gonna keep it going. So we can cut it
out. Yeah, okay.
I'll cut it out. This non-binary, I can't say guy.
Do you have like a way to cut like a thingamajiggy?
What's a thingamajiggy? Like a...
Your editing program looks better than what I have on my phone.
I just don't. You gotta explain better what you're asking for. What you're talking
about. Like a head marker?
A head marker? What is that?
Like a title marker. Just saying.
Yeah, I can do a title marker and stuff. I can do you know, just like a... Have you seen the episodes on Spotify?
Mm-hmm.
It cuts between them. I can do the same thing. I can leave the audio in and everything. I can really make the little...
Ha! You're doing that with this program, right?
I can do both.
How do you think the audio in UCut?
You know. Oh, no. I have to use this right here.
Okay.
But that's the... I put the whole video in.
Gotcha.
And I export it as a...
Alright, that's the problem I was having.
Gotcha. So this guy... Bro, I don't... I can't say guy, huh? This non-binary person, he's a top engine department wife. Look, bro. Oh, here we go. Samuel Ovis Brinton is an American nuclear engineer and an LGBTQ activist. He served as a deputy assistant secretary of Smith Fuel and Waste Disposition. I don't even know the words to explain. Maybe he's qualified. What position is he in? You know what? Maybe he's qualified. I don't know. LGBTQ, but we're trying to have them on our side. Here's a job. So I'm just going to say this. We're in a weird spot. You can wear a dress, you have a mustache, you can commit a crime and claim you're the opposite sex, and you live in that prison and get a bunch of people pregnant. And most of us are half. I don't know about these times, man. The more I think about it, the more I get into, not despair or anything, but it's more like, maybe we can survive being bad. Because a lot of us ain't smart. And a lot of us that ain't smart got good positions. Most of our leaders are in their 80s, so they don't even have a grip on what's going on here. That's a good point.
Just saying, right?
I'm just saying. Anyway, yeah, bro. What you got, George?
Just saying. Mine's not as despair written as yours, this George so Santos.
It's so stupid.
Alright, the lying senator, let's just talk about his track record. George Santos. These are some of the lies, not all, because I can't keep track of all of them. These are some of the lies this guy had. He stole checks from an elderly man. He created a charity for a homeless veteran's dog, and stole that money. He lied about his college degree. He lied about being a champion in that college. He lied about being Jewish. He said he was Jewish. He lied. He lied about his parents going through the Holocaust. He lied about his mom being a lion 11. He lied about cars and houses. There's a story about him lying about to his contractor, showing him that houses that he wanted him to fix up. He's like, this point of things was, like, yeah, I need you to move this, that, there, this, that, there, and this house, and this, that, there, and that house. So I mentioned he was a drag queen in Brazil. He lied about his name. Like, his name is not even George Santos.
These are the people leading us.
Yeah. Meanwhile, when Obama was running for president, it's like, that ain't the game for America.
He's an antichrist, him. But this is what I'm saying. Like, Obama was an antichrist, but you got a guy that's in BDSM wearing a dog mask. And I don't know what taking shit up that is or not. I don't know. He's non-binary, so maybe
I don't care for anything about that shit. But this is what I'm saying. This motherfucker lied about everything, everywhere, 17 ways from fucking Christ. And guess what they did? They gave him sin appointments. They didn't have to do that. That's not a thing that's mandatory. They didn't have to give him any fucking extra jobs to do. They gave him these jobs. You know why? Because they have a narrow minority. The Republicans have a narrow majority in the Senate. And they don't care about any fucking else but power and maintaining power. So they gave this lying piece of shit, evil person, more power than any person deserves being this person. They gave him that. They gave him an appointment. They put him on the chair of the, I'm going off script.
They're good. Take your time. But my point would be, they did the same thing for this Sam Britton guy. And he's a Democrat. Biden's a Democrat. These people are the same people. He's American.
Yeah. Anyway, a real nice thing, Britton. It was very poetic. It had some alliteration
in
there.
This is where I'm going. I know you're not a religious person. This is some satanic shit constantly happening. And these are the people in charge of it. So I was like, what are you doing? What are you doing? You're one of the people that hold the position in the White House. You're going to steal a woman's clothes. Go buy some woman's clothes. We know you wear a dress. He teaches their class, that's what he does. He teaches guys how to be the little kimpy guys with the mask on. Which again, which is cool, but why are you leading a nation of people? That's not... As far as history is concerned, the only reason we support... Well, maybe religion has a big point in that too. But it's the only cultures that move forward are the cultures that, again, that promote the heterosexuality. Because, again, man, woman makes children, you progress forever. We're at the point now where a person, maybe I should look this up. A person born does like 20 times, like they put 20 times more resources into the world opposed to taking out. Like that's where we're at with technology. It's actually a higher number than that. I did 20 to be safe. But it's crazy. I don't know what position he's at. Let me look at that. George Santos. What position he had?
He's a senator.
That's a lot of power, bro.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, they could have kicked him out. They could have done anything besides giving him more power inside the Senate. They would be like, hey, look, you got no committees. Like, you just hang out. The only thing they want is more power in the Senate. And so the bottom line is, the Republican Party, they don't care about you, they don't care about anything else, they just care about
what about the Democrats putting that guy in a position that's probably not even a real position, the other Sam Burton guy.
That's not like it. That's not like it.
No, they kept him to get the LGBTQ. He's like, oh, they vote with us, the Democrats like us. No, the fuck they don't. All these old white people don't like none of us. What are you talking about? Like, it doesn't matter, Democrat, Republican. These are the same people. Yes, they both want power, but they vote the same shit. Trump had documents at the House. Biden had documents at the House. It's, you know, these people were born into this. It doesn't matter what fucking... I'm being 100% honest. If you just think about the word democracy, and then you think of the two parties, Republic, which is obviously the one that they're going to pin as the one that's not a part of a democracy, and then Democrats is going to be obviously be the one built off of democracy, it is a big show. Like, this shit is bullshit. Not saying don't vote, because it'll have a fucking impact, but... It's a fucking TV show. And, you know, actually Trump is the one that kind of exposed that. Because he's a fucking TV show personality. Reagan was a TV show personality.
Reagan is my least favorite president. We'll talk about that next week. I'm glad he's dead. Fuck Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan is the reason we're in a lot of the mess that we are right now.
I think all of them are.
We'll elaborate on that. Next week.
Next week? What did Ronald Reagan next week?
What's Ronald Reagan next week? Fuck Ronald Reagan. Seriously.
Let's
give him an FBI list. I can't kill him again. He's already fucking dead. You know what? Ronald Reagan had Alzheimer's? Because his brain couldn't deal with all the horrible shit he did as a human.
You keep saying that. I don't think that's how Alzheimer's works.
Yeah.
I don't think that's what's going on, though. The damn Democrats was inflating the COVID numbers. They found out the real amount of people that died from COVID is only 30% of what they said.
that's good.
That's terrible. No, it's not. You lied to us for 3-4 years. These are Democrats. These are the people that want to get Trump out so they can have the power.
They're like, oh man, less people died.
They lied.
I'd rather, overestimate the death count than underestimate.
Oh, so you shut down the world for 30% less of the people when it already was 1% of the people? So 0.3 people died.
What's the problem with shutting down the world? What happens?
People die. People don't have money.
Oh, because money is our God.
No, because
money is our God. We got to God of money.
This is the second. No, this is like the fourth time you bring it up, and I keep saying you don't even understand the concept of God. How do you keep comparing something, a system that everybody can get paid and move up in, to God?
That's exactly God.
God is not a system at all.
My friend, I grew up in Catholic Church, and most of my aunts were nuns.
So
I understand God better than most. And God is money. God is capitalism.
I think you've actually been twisted because of your upbringing in it. Like, again, that's like saying the crusader that went to war because of the Pope telling him that he was going to be healed and not realize, oh, he doesn't fucking know what he's talking about.
He's going to move up in the system.
He's
that's
not
right.
God. This Pope is not God.
You're trying to prove my point. That's the exact same thing.
It's not the same thing. Because the person lied?
No, to the person, to the person on the battlefield it is.
No, just because you see, and that's another thing. You believe perception is reality. Perception is one person's reality. That one person was lied to, just because he believes something, doesn't mean it's true.
Yeah, but if a million people believe a thing, it becomes true.
It still doesn't have to be true. If we all believe that, again, fat people were healthy, doesn't make it true.
A million people believed in the Holocaust, and they killed a bunch of Jews, and that was true.
Even if they didn't believe that, like Kanye West or Kyrie Irving, quote unquote, allegedly, it still fucking happened.
Yeah, because more of us believe that it shouldn't.
That makes no sense. That makes absolutely no sense.
I'm not sure why you say it makes no sense.
You're just saying because the opposite is true.
No, I'm saying the opposite happened. Like, I'm not saying, because I'm saying they believed in the wrong thing. Like, a lot of people believed in the wrong thing. Yeah, the Holocaust is the wrong thing. I'm gonna do a hot take. Okay. There's a hot take. The Holocaust was bad. The Holocaust was bad. Shit that would happen. It was a bad thing that happened.
You're conflating two ideas, and the Holocaust happened, it was a bad thing. It's a
lawyer's idea, it's called overture.
Just because someone doesn't believe it happened doesn't mean it did not happen. Just because you believe the man that told you your sins will be taken from you and blah 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 does not mean that it's true. It's just what he told you and you either believe or don't believe. What is true, if you do believe, again, a person like myself, that I feel I've experienced results, evidence, of them being a God. First of all, like these people, these satanic people, like, I'll give a good example of why I believe the opposite, how the opposite is evidence of, you know, God, how the existence of Satan is obviously proof towards God. Again, these guys get positioned, these are drag queens, I'm not saying drag queen is wrong with them. These are guys that don't really have the strongest moral fiber. George Santos, this guy stealing luggage from the damn airport. All shit considered satanic shit, as in stealing, lying, and doing, and even if you go religious, wearing a dress, you pretend to be a woman is not, you know, godly. It's not what God is asking you to do. It's not what he says, if you do, you will live a life of fruitful, you know, you live a happy life. The fact that they, even transgender, the guy that started transgender, or started the debate that there is no gender, it's all society and stuff. Everything he literally said, he believes in the opposite of what's going on. He wants everything to be chaos. He doesn't want things to be in order and stuff like that. If they want chaos, if they want the opposite of what's going on, which is, again, our country is founded on we believe in God we trust. If they want to destroy that, constantly want to destroy it, like in the way that I couldn't even, they want my kid to go to a drag queen story hour. They want me to believe that there are no genders and stuff like that. They want to teach my kid that being the opposite of what they are, or feeling a certain way, makes them a completely different gender, a completely different type of human. That's all satanic shit. And there's people supporting it. Like, why do you have the pentagram? Why are you putting ball in the Balenciaga ass and shit? Which is, again, another name for the devil. Why are you guys worshiping the opposite while telling me that God doesn't exist, but you're worshiping the exact opposite? That's... I can't even... How could I explain this even deeper? there's such a contingent that people are bad, humanity is bad, and all this other stuff. That always ends with most of us dying. It's always rooted in...
This is very good TV.
It's not good TV at all.
Yeah, I mean, it's every TV show that we watch right now. That's The Walking Dead or Evil Dead or all the zombie TV shows, Last of Us, and that's pretty good.
It has nothing to do with satanic signals and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, I honestly cannot be more bored with satanic signals and stuff like that. But this is what I'm saying. Most of the arguments that I make is over to Mundo. It's the rationalized ridiculous argument with an even more ridiculous argument. So you said, what if God comes down and does something? The idea or concept of that is so ridiculous to me, I have to come up with a more ridiculous argument just to make you see how ridiculous your argument is.
Yeah, it doesn't work. That's why I explain to you every week the same thing. I know what you're talking about. I said that the first episode with you. That's why your analogies will always be so off. That's why I was like, hey, your analogies are crazy. Because it's not...
Yeah.
What you're trying to do is just prove what I'm saying.
It bounces back in future.
Even with us talking just now, you conflating you not believing in Catholicism because of your upbringing, that's one religion talking about God.
Yeah.
Even if that one religion is wrong, literally thousands of years, our entire society across the world, any progressive society, is built off of those principles. So again, if it doesn't exist, then the idea of morality and things like that go out the window. We fall apart as a fucking species.
God is not moral.
He's very moral.
No, he is not. God is not moral. God is not just. God is not spacious. I mean, not your God. Your God is very limited.
Your God is very what?
Limited. Your God is the Christian God, right?
You think limited because it doesn't want to affect your free will?
No, your God is limited because he lets people get raped, murdered.
That's not limited. He lets people do what they want to do.
Oh! Then that's a good God. Then fuck that nigga.
No, it is what it is. He told you what will happen.
So let God come at me, bro.
That's the same God you're talking about in Catholicism.
Yeah.
That's one of the main points is you can do what you want to do. What's going to happen to you after this life, though, is not going to be something you want.
Exactly. That was the point of the Unchained Gospel, which is one of my favorite things in the universe. We should go a second about the Unchained Gospel. That's my point of...
What you just say, you got to slow it down. What you say?
Unintended consequences.
Unintended consequences.
That's one of my favorite points. We should come back to that again. That's one of my favorite segments.
No, the consequence to you.
Either way, the imaginary friend you have. But unintended consequence is one of the things that happened with the French Revolution. Because what's worse than being anything besides going to hell? Nothing. And so if we kick your door down, kill your daughter, kill your wife, kill your family, and torture you until you admit that you're a witch. There's nothing worse than that.
You don't think that's hell?
What?
You don't think...
So their mind, that's not worse than hell.
You don't think that's hell? And this is the thing. They say afterlife, right. But my point...
This is my example. Alright, say your neighbor next door, right? They don't believe in God. So somebody comes in their house, they kick in the door, kill his wife, kill his kids. They tell him, he's like, believe in God. And he's like, I guess, yeah. And they kill him. And they're like, well, at least he went to heaven. Is that fine?
It's not fine because he's fucked up.
But what's worse than going to hell?
Living a life without faith. That is hell.
Exactly. So it's fine to kill him, right?
First of all, if you're dead...
Because at least he didn't go to hell.
Every problem we ever had is happening during our life.
At least you can go to hell, correct?
If you're dead.
What is worse than that?
You don't have any issue.
Then what's the problem with that scenario? What if they tortured his wife and family and kids for they believe in God? Is that fine?
And then they killed him.
No, what if they just torture him? They torture him until they believe in God. Is that okay?
Why would they torture him until they believe in God?
Not because. What's worse than going to hell? This is the French Revolution. This literally happened. This is the thing that happened. The French Revolution, they broke out cats and nine tails and all this kinky shit that made people believe in God. They beat them and subjugated them and tortured them until they believe in God. So what's worse?
And here comes
a man. And not the logic's sound. The logic is sound.
And here you come
what is worse than going to hell?
A person taking a faith and turning it into what they want to. That would be considered a satanic thing. They're trying to manipulate the teachings of, again, read the teachings, understand the teachings. This is all positive. Fear is not even a part of it. Fear is
the way to dark side, I get it.
Yeah, in Star Wars. But fear
it's all make believe. It's the same thing. You know, it all equates.
And all this. And this is very good. It's an interesting conversation because literally everybody I don't believe, they have this thing about them that, you know, like maybe they buy more stuff than usual, or there's something missing. There's a lack of contentment. And you do have that. I'm not saying it's a bad thing because you seem all right. There's such a hole in who you become that it's not scary. It's almost, I can't say shameful, because it is what you are. What can I say? You're my guy anyway.
Yeah, I just can't believe the Santa Claus. I'm sorry.
And this is
it's a fun thing to believe. I don't believe in God. Dude, I remember my mom was like dying on her deathbed. She was laying there, she was like, oh man, call the priest. I was like, yeah, you call him, make believe ass priest and like let him pray over your dead body. It's fun. It's like most, and it gave him such comfort. But I mean, it's not a real thing. And like, so the knowledge of a make believe
thing. This is what it comes into. This is what I always run into with you. Perception is reality on one hand. But if you believe in this, it doesn't exist. Even though you believe in it, it doesn't exist. Most people on the planet believe that there is a God or something.
Mm-hmm.
But still to you, you're like, oh, even though all those people believe it, it still doesn't exist.
Mm-hmm.
So I need you to have a kind of congruent, like you have to keep it all. If my perception and most people's perception is they believe in God, then he does exist. If there are people actually worshiping the opposite of him, Satan, that means God exists, because he's the opposite. It's like this argument you had a while back of, oh, Walmart's such a big company, I wish a government would step in and, you know, because they don't pay them enough, give them some type of, they need some type of help to pay for their food. They already had
no, Walmart's such a big company that they use the government to subsidize their employees. Like, Walmart doesn't pay their employees enough, and so, like, 30% of Walmart employees are on welfare, so we're paying for Walmart employees. But Walmart is making record profits, but we're paying Walmart employees to work at Walmart. So we buy stuff from Walmart, and then we pay the Walmart employees, and then we pay them again.
You're asking for that. You're saying, you told me, you wish there was some type of government subsidy that would help people pay, help me keep my staff in order.
That's not what I said. I said I wish that the government would make Walmart pay their employees more.
They can only make them pay what they can make you pay. So, again, y'all the same people, but you're talking about them because they're bigger and better.
Yeah, it's fair enough. I mean, they make more money. I can't afford to pay my employees like $20 an hour.
And shouldn't that be on you to make more money?
I guess so, but Walmart's making record profits every week and they can't pay their employees more.
What does that have to do with their profits? They're
unionized.
Paying what they're supposed to.
They should unionize.
They probably have tried. They probably do have a union that Walmart owns. But back to my point about this whole God thing, because it's such a weird argument to continue to say, oh, you're imagining your friend, oh, and this and that, but this is my perception. If this was a couple weeks ago, you'd be like, oh, it must be true because you believe. So what if, it seems so personal, and it's most people that don't believe. It's such a personal, I'm so much smarter, I get it so much, like, there's nothing bigger than humanity to the people that believe that there is no God. And it's like, you're not even the biggest thing on the planet. There's still places on the planet that we have no fucking idea about. Yeah, we're pretty good, but we're not the best at anything.
I'm not sure you can cut this, but can you cut to Ant's face?
No.
Okay.
In ant's face?
Yeah, if you Google, somebody like took a close-up picture of an ant in their face.
You just Google it for you right now?
Yeah.
Why?
You might have to see a close-up. Yeah! It's terrifying, right?
This is the thing, you always throw some random, you know, whatever into it when you feel like you're losing or you feel like, you know, that's a good point of it.
It's not this is the way I talk. I don't know. Everything seems the same to me.
So what does this have to do with most people that don't believe shit? They look like this is what you're saying?
No.
Most people that don't believe there's a decay that happens within them. And it's an obvious thing, it's certain things that fall apart. And you said before, you asked me before if I think being a guy for your mind makes you rich or whatever, but it's like, we're not worried about
it. It wasn't that bad. I said, the thing I said was, most people believe when you're rich, you are a God-fearing man.
Right.
That's not the same.
I don't agree with that. But
most people do.
Most people are dumb. Most people have never even touched the type of money that, you know, some of these guys were born into. But this whole capitalism is God thing. It's conflating two things that have nothing to do with each other. It's a human-made thing plus a thing that's much bigger than you. And you're conflating them to the same thing because you don't understand the thing. You can't comprehend something bigger than humanity. It's like, well, that's a you issue. Like, there's so many things bigger than this.
I think on this planet, there's nothing bigger than humanity. That sounds like a facetious statement, but yeah, there really isn't.
There's not even. So, okay, I'll give you that statement. Now, what about all the other planets? What about the whole system in general? Oh, there was a Big Bang. Okay, what caused the Big Bang? Oh, you know, we can see atoms. We can manipulate atoms. Okay, go to a quark.
We're not saying we control the universe or understand the whole thing, because we definitely cannot, but we definitely are, as far as we know, the brain of the universe. Because there ain't nothing else there thinking or like doing rules for us right now. So we just gotta do our best to be the brain, the conscience, the thoughts, the cares, and the feelings of the universe.
So again, going back to this French Revolution thing. Since you believe that, that's people being assholes to people. That has nothing to do with a guy that, again, most of the population, I think still most of the population.
Oh, like, Spanish Inquisition, sorry.
Was it the Spanish Inquisition? Yeah, we're talking about Crusaders. Just because people manipulate things to get their own point across, which again is a satanic thing, and again, Democrats and Republicans do it, politicians in general do it, it doesn't make it a godly thing. It will never click to me how a system, which is put in place for you to make money and live a life without having to grow your own resources and go up.
This is all I'm saying. It's like, I'm not saying it's a godly thing or an ungodly thing. I'm saying this is what it is.
No, you're saying it's our God. It's like,
oh, it is, because we worship it. We endorse it. We green stamp it. We thumbs up it every time we see it.
We green stamp it because it's the best system available for people to get by.
That's God. That's the exact difference of God.
That is not the exact difference of God. Look it up.
How would you define God? And your how would you define God?
I'm going to look it up.
And your personal definition.
My personal definition is.
So look up definition doesn't mean anything.
A being much greater than us that really is controlling it. Not even controlling it as far as I have my hand here and using a controller. I'm going to make you do what I want you to do. But a being so benevolent that he's not concerned with what you can possibly do. Matter of fact, everything that you're going to do doesn't matter to me to the point where, here's Merriam-Webster's, to the point where you can do whatever you like. You can literally do whatever you like. If you were a good person, I have a place for you. Here we go. The supreme or ultimate reality.
The being perfect
in power, wisdom, and goodness who is worshipped, as in Judaism, Christianity, Islam, Hinduism, as creator and ruler of the universe. So capitalism is the creator and ruler of our entire universe?
Yeah.
It didn't create our universe.
America did.
No, it didn't. That was slavery at first. And we were selling that's
bartering.
That's bartering. Literally. They used to sell goods to each other.
Why do you fight so hard on this? You don't even like God.
It's not fighting. First of all, I love God. Second of all,
we do not.
Now you're telling me I don't love my own God?
Yeah, you don't like that nigga.
See, that's what I'm saying. You just get more and more ridiculous to the point where you just sound ridiculous. And I'm just sitting here, I keep coming with points, but you keep getting more and more ridiculous, and we just end up sitting here being ridiculous. Because you can't conflate a money system. Let me look up the fucking definition of capitalism. To God. Especially if you don't even believe in the God. That doesn't make any sense.
Curious.
You have no concept of what God is, but you're saying.
I mean, only in the theological sense.
No, that's the only sense that God exists. He is God. What are you talking about?
I understand God the way I've read Harry Potter books. I've read them all.
That's a man-made thing.
No, we agree.
A story. No, we don't agree.
It's a man-made thing.
This is what you believe. So capitalism, you're not getting a high five for that.
There's a fly!
an economic and political system in which a country's trade and industry are controlled by private owners for profit.
Sounds like thousands to me.
Just because they need money to run them, does that mean that's what they're worshiping? The supreme or ultimate reality. Let's go back.
This seems like a big tree I'm talking down.
No, I think you're growing that tree. Capitalism is also thought as an economic system in which private actors own and control property in accord with their interests and demand supply, freely set prices and markets in a way that can serve the best interests of society. The essential feature of capitalism is unwilling to make a profit. Again, people want to survive, and you're conflating people surviving to worship. Look up worship. Just because I need money to survive don't mean I fucking worship. If I worship it, I'll be out there on my hands and knees to a dollar bill or some shit. Well, again, kissing people's ass for money. I don't kiss somebody's ass for money. The feeling, worship, the feeling or expression of reverence and adoration for a deity.
Because he sees money.
No one worships money except for greedy people, which is again against the very teachings of a god. If you worship a god, that's not what you're going for. It's like you're taking the people that disrespect or don't follow the teachings, and it's like, oh, because you're human, you believe in God.
Are you saying capitalism is Satanism?
I'm saying capitalism is a system in which a country would use, just like they're saying here, which I've been saying for weeks now, to make money, to keep track of people being able to buy food, buy services, buy goods.
And I feel like you're taking this out of context. Here's my main argument. I'm going to run it back one more time. I did it in an episode.
Keep going.
During the pandemic, people were dying. Yes, no.
Because of what?
Not because of a disease.
No. Not as many as they said.
No. Were people dying? Yes or no?
People die every day.
Were people dying because of disease? Yes or no?
Not that I'm aware of. No.
Oh, so no one died. Oh, right. I guess the show's over. No one died of the pandemic. Hey, guys, if your uncle died or anybody else died because of the pandemic, I guess I'll see you later. Oh, shit. A lot of my family died because of the pandemic. Let's just cut to the chase.
I'm aware of.
People, my family personally died.
I'm aware of that. I had personal loss. I understand that. And you keep making it personal because you're going to incite the emotion. You're not going to incite the emotion from me. You experienced it, so you're saying, okay, it was that bad. I'm telling you, as a person that did not
die all the time.
That's my point. Right, you don't have to bring up, oh, but my family, well, I'm
sorry. I'm just saying, you're saying I didn't personally experience it. I did.
I did not.
Huh? But you didn't, so I guess it doesn't matter to you.
Oh, we both
it doesn't,
two people?
It doesn't
so
matter.
You would say half the people in this room
did not? It doesn't matter who dies as long as it doesn't affect you. That's why I know you live in.
No, it matters to
you. No, it doesn't. You're very civic in the things you say.
Yeah, that's what
I'm saying. No one I know died, it didn't happen. So I get it.
No, it was not.
No,
it seems like more to you
that's
because
you
it
said.
Happened to you.
No, it didn't happen to you, so it doesn't matter.
No, it didn't happen to me, so I cannot speak on something that did not happen to me when the numbers are
but
telling me.
But you can read a book.
Yeah, you the numbers are telling me that the deaths weren't as much as they were saying, which means just like any other time or day, even though they were saying, oh, you got into a car accident and died from a car accident, that's COVID. I'm saying, one, we didn't have to shut
down. Your argument's officious and very glib. You need to, like, check your sources. This is all I'm saying. People actually died from the pandemic. You shouldn't disagree with that. Did people die during the pandemic? Yes or no?
No.
No one died during the pandemic?
No, I'm not going to just boil it all to the pandemic. If that's the case, how many people killed the Spanish who died in the fucking, what you call it? In the Black Plague and shit.
There's numbers for that. Maybe
yeah,
right
a
now.
Much larger
how?
Number.
Oh,
this
there's numbers for that. Look up how many people died during the pandemic, and let's go with that.
No, I can't go with that because they were conflating every...
you don't
every,
believe that.
Why they were conflating every
why
death.
Why do you believe people
with,
died in the Spanish flu? Yeah.
They conflated every
then
single death.
Then why do you believe people died in the Spanish flu?
Finish my point. This is my point here. If I die from a car accident and happen to have COVID, they said it was COVID. Just because your family, even if it's a large number
if you
of
died
your
car
family,
you had COVID, did you not have COVID?
Can I finish my point? You didn't die from COVID, though. They said the cause of death was COVID. It was not.
No one was driving during COVID, dude. I used to bike. I didn't even know
I drove
brakes.
Every day. I'm delivering pizzas for you.
Dude, I did not have my brakes for COVID.
By the way, I'll keep saying, just because people died during the pandemic does not mean it's because of the actual pandemic. That's my point.
So you're saying no one died because of the pandemic.
Let me finish my point. No, I'm not going to just say generalize all the deaths that happened during the pandemic, which they said it was, which it was not apparently, because it wasn't that.
This is not even my argument. This is like the basic beginning. I was saying did anybody die because of the pandemic? You said no.
I said no. I won't get into this because of the fact that you're conflating every death that happened during the pandemic. You have to understand
that I can't even start my conversation because you won't agree that anybody died during the pandemic.
You won't take what I'm saying at face value. Literally, what I'm saying, not every death that happened during the pandemic, quote unquote, which was not a pandemic.
But you have to understand that I can't even start my sentence because you won't agree on the basic reality that people died during the pandemic.
My point is,
I can let you finish.
Then let me finish.
But I'm trying to finish for like 10 minutes. And Taylor Swift didn't deserve that award.
See, this is my point. You just get more and more ridiculous into this no anything. To me, that's a man without faith. That's people that don't have an understanding that if you don't follow certain principles, it affects you in a way that is negative. That ends up being a satanic type thing. Your mindset ends up so blurred and so strange. Man, even your health deteriorates. Like, I don't understand how you can put a system put into place for people to keep track of, grow money, and take care of their families without stealing, killing, or doing anything. Really, principles based in religion, like we were founded, and say it's the same thing as a god. It's like, no. This system is literally based off of the systems that we learn from their religion.
Curious.
This system is based on money. It's not about worship. We want you to work. So again, we don't. Same people that.
I'm not even trying to get into a microcosm. I'm just trying to get into a shared reality. Do you agree that people died because of the pandemic?
What part of the pandemic?
I don't care.
The shutdown.
I don't care.
I do care. I'm trying to specify.
And that's what I'm saying. That you got to agree on that one single part. That's where we're breaking down. Because you do not accept reality. That's the part that people who believe in religion believe in. They believe in all this make-believe. They believe in all this Harry Potter shit that makes them think that there's all this humble jumbo hocus-pocus magic things that there's a make-believe, almost make you God in the sky that will protect them. But really, this is facts and data.
When did I say it's going to protect me?
Oh, buddy, he's not.
When did I say he was? Again, I keep saying the principles of things that we're taught and that keeps us moving forward as a society without falling into chaos and confusion. Just like right now, I'm trying to be specific about what you're talking about. Like, are you saying, because people die every day. It's not the pandemic anymore. They're still dying. My point is the same. These people, a lot of these, of all the COVID deaths they reported, 30% were actually, they got COVID, had a heart attack, had a stroke from that, they died. Everything else was, oh, you died, you had cancer, it doesn't matter, you had COVID too, so COVID killed you.
It's not the way.
And you just said, you're basing your shit on facts, and I'm making make-believe. No, these are the facts. This is what's coming out now. The facts of the matter is, they were lying a lot about these vaccines and stuff that was saving people. It didn't save anybody. Did your family get vaccinated?
Yeah, all of
them. And they still died.
No, it's going to uncle because he didn't get vaccinated.
Then how are you saying all these people died?
The only reason he didn't tell us that he was sick was because he knew we all go see him and we all get sick. It was really funny. He got sick and died like at the beginning of COVID, and he told nobody because he knew we'd come and go see him, and he just fucking died by himself, and he just died, and everybody's like, oh shit, why didn't you tell us he was sick? Go see him. I was like, yeah, that's why we didn't tell y'all he was sick.
And now it's my turn. That's what I'm saying about yourself and people that don't believe in a system of at least some type of positivity, which again goes back to these religions, which are promoting positive things.
Oh, religion's the worst.
You will go into the most how can I explain it? Like, uneducated. Just you learning over me is not going to stop me from saying what I'm saying. Like, just because you don't believe it doesn't mean you've insulted my religion or my faith like 6-7 times.
I think you're religious, though.
This is
my point. Do you go to church, or?
I go to church every week.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, there's a lot you don't know. That's my point. So for you to be, and we just had a discussion, for you to be so sure and such a arrogant person about I'm so positive that that doesn't happen because, you know, I read Harry Potter and I'd be like, what the fuck?
I was equating your religion with Harry Potter. Your religion is not as believable as Harry Potter.
That's what I just said. Well, I read Harry Potter, so, you know, people believe that, but Harry Potter was written by a person.
No, I was saying your religion is Harry Potter. I was saying it's the exact
same thing. That's what I'm saying to you.
There's no simile, I was saying it's the exact same thing.
I know what you're saying. You keep interrupting because I hope you feel, well, you don't ever feel anything. So, again, it brings back to my point of these people that don't believe anything, there's such a hole in them that it forces me to believe in a God or so. Because everyone that's not believing, there's this certain deterioration of it that is so, I would say gross, but it's like, well, that's normal. That's, you know, that's what happens to me now. That's what happens when you choose to chaos over some type of order just because it's order. Or you're gonna not believe in this because all these people believe in it and they abuse it. It's like, well, they abused it. You also acknowledge that they abuse it, and you're gonna be like, oh, well, so that thing must be terrible? No, you're saying that they are abusing a nice positive thing for their own gains, which is said directly by the religions is a satanic thing, and you're still gonna be like, oh, no, this is a storybook. Well, that storybook has saved a lot of people. I know you say, oh, you know, they lied to the Crusaders during the Spanish Inquisition. Yeah, they lied, which is not something that man of God would do. It's not something that an actual man of God would do. It's that simple. It's not all this other stuff, all this Harry Potter and shit. Like, it's probably the greatest story. It's one of the oldest stories in our history. And we're finding out that a lot of stuff that we were talking about, these little wives' tales or, you know, whatever type of stories, there's a hint of truth. We're just misinterpreting it every time. If I go just off that basis, the fact that we're not understanding what they were trying to say fully, and everyone doesn't understand it the same way, but it's like saying, okay, I don't understand the law because, you know, I want to smoke weed, and they say I can't smoke weed, and that's just evil because if I smoke weed, I'm in a better mood and I treat people better. What about the people that don't? What about people that don't smoke weed and their fucking behavior is shit? Like, their behavior goes from being considerate to inconsiderate. What about the people that run into accidents and shit that do smoke weed or drink and do all this other shit? We're going to say, no, let's not do that because not everyone, but the people that don't follow this end up this happening. I just don't get it. Like, okay, let's say, what's another system besides capitalism?
Oh, yeah, that's neat. I had no fucking idea. I'm not great at systems.
So you don't even have another system?
I can barely make a system to wash dishes. It's getting out of control.
So you don't even have another system to put in place? At least we have Catholicism, Hinduism, Islam, all these things that believe that there is a God. That I can inter-switch if I don't like this one, or this one doesn't work, or if this one is wrong, go here, and still live in positivity as opposed to negativity.
And that's the reason. That's the reason religion is so great. I mean, it gives you something, and I give you nothing. I can offer you nothing but the truth, which is there is no God, there is no masters.
And how
be good to people. Oh, because if it is, hey God, this is me, Yancy. Eat a dick.
Again. How can you be so sure that you can do that? It's free will. You can say whatever.
I know, but I guess like when we get there, like. You could be like, Nancy, I told you so. And God would be like, that's the nigga told me you did.
Where you're at.
Oh,
I'm not going to be where you're at. I even believe, I'll take it as far
as... Isn't that like a gateway or something?
I'll take it as far as it happens during your life. You don't realize it, but your life starts to fall apart. You start to really... No, to not feel anything is such a terrible, terrible thing. To not feel anything...
I feel like that's a thing, too. I feel like that's... You feel like anybody who falls upon misfortune is frowned upon by God.
I was living in my car...
You were never frowned upon by God, though, dude. You were still, like, blessed.
That's misfortune,
though. It is misfortune, but you weren't, like... You weren't in the shadow of God. You were still, like, loved. Like, you still had, like, resources. You can still help you. You're saying every homeless person on the street is just like, you're done. God hates you. Yeah?
I never said that.
That's the theory.
Who's This is what, that's not the theory.
I'm just taking your theory to the conclusion. You're saying when you're homeless, right?
That's what makes you think they're not happy?
Being homeless? No one's happy being homeless.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you're...
How can you be so sure?
Because I talk to him, dude. I hang out with homeless people.
Just because a motherfucker comes and is asking you for something, and he's
Literally hang out with homeless people. I drink beers with them.
How homeless are they if they hang out with you?
Because I buy beers. You not read my Facebook stories?
How happy are they drinking the beer?
Because they got beer. Well, yeah, they all got sad stories, dude. Only thing they have offers is beer.
I'm not homeless right now. I got a sad story.
You got a sad story in the roof.
Now I do, yeah.
But yeah, I don't like hang out with homeless people every day, but like, there's been like several cases where I've been hanging out with homeless people drinking a six pack.
No matter how many several cases you can have as a human being, you do not know the entire populace of homeless. They have a system of life, they literally have a system to maintain the life that they have.
Bruh. You're really stressed on this God thing. But anyway.
Stressing? That's not stress, that's not a fact.
Stretching.
That's, you stretch to homeless people, not me. What makes you think a homeless person is sad?
Because I talk to them.
I talk to a lot of people that tell me a sad story, that doesn't mean that they're sad.
No, I mean, there's
people that will tell me a happy story, that doesn't mean that they're happy. Just because I'm going through something at the moment, like, I was upset earlier, I was tired earlier, I was not having a good time. Does that mean I'm just a sad person?
Curious. No.
These generalizations are crazy. Like, how can you generalize so much? That's a lot of people you're talking about. You think that they want to be a part of what we're doing? You don't think that they think we're crazy?
Fair enough.
They stay on the corner and people give them money. They get paid to stay on the corner.
Next week, we'll do a segment with homeless people.
I'm not doing a segment with homeless people.
I'll do it myself. I'll send it to you.
All right.
That's the police.
Yeah, I guess we said peace, you know, I don't know.
We guess one more thing we want to do. Did we do movie reviews? Did Just Sam?
I did Just Sam. I was going to do what shows we were watching, what games we were playing these days. What, man, you're so far off the mark in my opinion.
You too.
Capitalism is God, man. You still haven't...
I'm going to get you off that make-believe stuff.
You still haven't even... And that's... You're never going to get me off of it again.
You're not
a person that... How are you going to convince me that your life is better than my life?
Can we do a comeback? Or...
Right now?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know, because it's like...
Why do you keep gonna cut and come back? Like, what? What's on your mind?
Because it sounds different than the tone that was hitting.
We can just split it, put some type of thing in the middle, and, you know... put a transition in the middle and it looks like a cut. I'm just not, what are you trying to
do? Oh, it's fine. It's just because
I'm
intimately close with your God. Your version of it.
You don't know my version of it.
Fair, because no one can. This is your God. Because you know who God is?
A complete and supreme reality. Thank you.
It is you. It's right there, buddy. It's in your heart. Your God.
Was that supposed to convince me?
No, not really. It was never.
I'll bring you to another area on this. What about your life is so great that I should just not believe it? What makes it so much better that not believing? What practice do you know that you are like, you know, they taught you that in religion, you should not do that because it's fucking you up in this way.
There's really nothing. There's honestly no benefit to believing what I believe. There's honestly only detriment. It'll make you feel worse. It'll make you perform less at sports and be more depressed.
Does it make you perform less at sports?
Yeah, because you ever like looks at like you ever seen a Super Bowl and the guy's like, I thank God. You can't do that if you don't believe in me. Like, I think, I don't know.
He can thank himself.
I think, I don't know, gravy.
He can thank his mom. He can thank anybody he wants to
thank. Yeah, it's never happened. I always thank God.
Right, because they believe in God. Those particular people believe in God. That's not every single player.
Yeah, it's not every single player. Only the great ones. So, I mean, you can't, like, really do that. Like, believing the truth kind of sucks. So, I mean, I don't see
it. What way does believing the truth suck?
Oh, because you just can't. Like, once you see it, you can't unsee it. It's kind of like one of those things, like, once you know Santa Claus isn't real when you were a child, And I was like, oh man, there's no red. Do you ever moon cycle? You've never moon cycle. I see you.
Yeah, I believe
in Santa. Oh, nice, cool.
My
yeah.
Yeah.
Once you don't believe Santa Claus, like, you can't see the red dude slide down your chimney and like give him presents and stuff like that. It's kind of silly, but
I'm still waiting, man. I'm like, just make it make sense. I'm not tripping. Whatever you got to say is what you got to say. I'm not, you know, it's really hard to offend me. I like to pretend, but I don't fucking care. Say what you got to say.
Yeah, that's. I realized it when I've seen more people die than most. I have a really big family. So I've been by their bedside, I've held their hands, like in the moments and stuff like that.
You just sound like, you feel like the religion or the belief in God is causing that pain.
Oh no, it caused them great, like, comfort. It's been the most comfort. So like, I can't imagine, like, I know I'm gonna die eventually. I can't imagine dying and believing, not believing in God.
So you're saying because it's comfortable that it's wrong?
No.
I'm
just saying that it just is. Like, I've held their hands. I've been with priests in their rooms, by their bedside, praying, giving them comfort, like, hands on. I've seen, like, way more people in my youngish life die in a bed of their choosing. I have a big family.
Mm-hmm.
My mom has a simple assistant.
Yeah,
so I've seen people like take their last breath before and be comfortable and go with the grace of God. And I've known the entire time that I was made to leave.
Okay.
But I felt comfort.
How do you know
I felt comfort in the fact that they felt comfort.
How do you know it was meant to leave? Because you don't feel it?
No, it's not a feel thing, it's just like a no.
Because you don't see it? This is my point. You admit to be arrogant, you admit to not being the highest.
Super arrogant.
And yet you can't admit the fact that... Never mind, let me just... So, what makes you not believe?
Make it make sense. If you can make the God make... If you can make the whole God thing make sense to me, it'd be fun. Please help, man. I was raised by nuns.
I don't know what else
but also, the rest of the story isn't in your business. Get it, nuns? Huh? Next week! Make it make sense! Let's talk about God.
You want to do a God topic next week?
Make it make sense.
I could probably find you a video right now. But,
I would like you to make it make sense to me.
Okay, I guess I'll watch it. Okay.
Oh, you can send it to me. I'll watch it also.
No, I'm going to make it make sense to you. I'm going to go ahead and do my little research and we're going to talk about it. In a world where there are people literally worshiping the opposite, that should be enough evidence that there is, in fact, a God. When you worship, when you are putting a pictogram on things and saying things like Baal is king and, you know, very strange things.
But hey, the one, I live in the store and my receipt total is 666 and I got down.
Those are numbers.
I got down last. You
didn't get down. The reason I cut you off, because I get it, it's going to be a joke, but. If you want to talk serious about it, let's talk serious about it, dog. If there's people that worship the opposite, if there's people that constantly plan and engage in destroying the human race by saying things like the environment's going to shit, and we do stuff like cut coal and cut oil and all this stuff, I'm sure there's a positive force on the other side.
Wait, what?
If there's an evil force that's convincing people, yeah, again, humans are evil, and that we're destroying everything, and we're doing all this, and they're openly expressing pentagrams as a symbol of the devil, saying Baal is king, and stuff like Balenciaga and stuff.
You said cutting the oil?
Again, Baal is king in their Balenciaga ads. They believe that if they, fossil fuels and stuff, if you cut fossil fuels, you know, 500,000 people would die. Like, is it 500 million? Either 500,000 or 500 million people would die across the planet. That's not wrath.
Show your math.
That's people. Let me look it up.
Show your math.
All right, give me 1 second. I'm just going to ask how many people would die if you cut fossil fuels.
Also, that's a very spacious and dumb argument. They also said that they didn't have enough people to maintain the food supply that we have right now. You know who said that? The guy who killed all the Jews.
Some Democrat.
No, it was a Jew. He's the guy who invented Agent Orange. He was also Jewish.
Are you aware of what Canada is about?
You said cannabis?
Canada.
Canada?
Let's see. This is for your air
pollution. Ooh, pause for a second. I gotta pee.
So even if carbon emissions stop completely right now, it's also special with the atmosphere. The Earth's temperature will rise by another 1.1.
This is an extra second.
There's no research on this at all. Every day, 10,000 people die due to air pollution, it says.
Who's grabbing one? That's you.
This is, again, not a mentor.
Oh, sorry! Everyone has bounced that up.
There's a paradox in the notion of whether we can know God exists. And the paradox is, in part, you can't know God. And so, can you know that something exists that you can't understand? And the answer is, well, then maybe that's why you only see God's back in some real sense, right? You get hints. And maybe you get hints if you open yourself up in the right way. And one of the ways you open yourself up in the right way is not to ask for what you want in that God is a celestial butler manner, but the to ask how it is that to transform yourself so that you can be a better agent of the divine will or something
right.
like that.
And then what do you find when you do that? When you embrace responsibility, what you find is meaning. Which is a route to the divine.
Well, the secularists would say, well, without God, you can still find meaning in service to others. And I would say, yes, that's true. But the reason you find meaning in the service to others is because that's one step on the ladder to the divine. Well, Nietzsche said, God is dead, and what's going to happen? Nihilism?
That's a good old nihilism.
Back to the guys. That camera's still fucked up.
I can't see it. Which one is it?
Alright, Dr. Peterson said it. A lot better than I did.
Even for real in this setup?
Yeah. You just mean no more. Just don't have a third one. I'm not going to use a third one. It's when we do vampires and hookers, I'm there. But the same thing with what Dr. Peterson is saying is the same thing I'm saying. The pursuit of the things that religion teaches you are so much more positive than the opposite. And when you see people that actively go against it, and you even slipped and said a minute ago how you were going to take me out of believing that for whatever reason. I don't know why you think not believing it would be better, which is what we got into a minute ago.
It's really not.
But what he's saying basically is, just because you haven't opened up to the way that, what's the word? Like, you will not open yourself up to the idea of it for whatever reason. And that causes you some type of, angst. You have called yourself an idol before we've had the conversation. Maybe not on camera, maybe it was on camera. That leading you, when I was working for you at G's, there's a lot of complaints because you wouldn't kind of take a charge and like Jelly would come in, not Jelly, but whatever that chick name, it is Jelly. She would come and complain, yes, you won't do this and blah, 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 that, blah, blah, blah. You end up with these workers that don't, I'll explain it. Well, you end up with, like that cook we ended up dealing with, a guy that can't even get a woman and keep a woman. You end up with these people that are so low on the competence scale. In life.
Yeah, they can't like get direction.
Yeah, but these people aren't the people that are believing, that are following the doctrine of their religion.
Mm-hmm.
That should be evidence enough. Right? Mm-hmm. Everyone that is against it is not necessarily, not everyone. Well, for me, in my experience, most people that have not believed in it, like, you do well, you do well, you're a business owner. Do I think you do better? I don't fucking know, because I don't know, you know. But these people that don't, the way they carry themselves, the things that they do, like, again, this guy's stealing luggage from women's luggage from an airport when he wasn't even on a plane. This guy. A lot of these people that are confusing these genders and saying that it doesn't exist because of this and that are the same people that are like, oh, God is just a hoax, it's just a fairy tale. So my gender's a fairy tale too? These are the same people that wants the world to end. These are the same people talking about we have to cut everything right now because we're destroying everything. When it's not even the case. Again, we've gone over the world is greener now because there's more CO2. You were right about the Montreal Protocol, I assume. You know, they said on, was it Twitter? I sent you the thing. That, you know, it's still decreasing, blah, blah, blah. We found it out. We started researching it. Well, my point would always be the same. The people that are believers of the, I guess, divine rules, or I don't know what you would call it. I'm not a priest or a pastor. The people that follow that doctrine, they seem calmer. They seem to not need as much material or, you know, things that are negative to keep them sustained. They don't have to fuck over people. I personally don't have to fuck over people. I don't have to do anything negative. I don't have to talk shit. I don't have to do this. I don't have to, you know, put people down. I don't have to shame them. I don't have to throw weird, you know, ridiculous statements in their way so they can't focus and stuff. No, I don't have to do that. I just be straight up and it's going to come through. I don't have to, you know, sweat. I don't have to be in a pit of people DJing for them, you know, and entertaining them constantly to make them feel like, you know, I'm somebody they can be around. I don't need it. I don't have to do it. I don't have to, you know, cater to really any type of superficial type thing to feel needed or wanted. I mean, don't worry about it. This is not on my mind. I've never run into a situation where I can't think of a single situation where it just didn't work out in a positive manner. I can't think of a single situation where even death, people think of death as negativity. If you die, I mean, I don't think that's very negative. You just dead.
You just kind of got it. You don't have a choice.
You're all going to go eventually. I don't see how that makes, you know, God non-existent. I don't see how, I see how it makes him exist in the sense of there was somebody that taught us this. Or someone that is saying this, that is, again, upholding those rules to some degree, because it's pretty evident, to me at least, in my opinion, that those that believe, they have a very certain way of carrying themselves. And it's a, there's a contentment. There's just a cool nature about whatever they are. They're not running after money. They're not greedy. They're not, you know, really heavy into anything. Anything that'll destroy them. There's nothing about them that... Mm-hmm. Again, we were talking about the homeless a second ago. I can't say that they're sad. They probably think we're dumb for giving them money. They probably think you're stupid for buying them a beer.
And once again, like I said, I literally talked to them. I employed the homeless.
Yeah.
Like, I stand on the back of a million homeless people. That's not a flex. But still, like, I give them money. They help me out a lot.
That statement is fucked up. You stand on the back of homeless people?
Dude, theology.
What's their benefit? I don't stand on the back of no goddamn homeless person. What are you talking about?
I'm a giant. It's a push three quote.
This is what, look how
it's a push three quote.
Look how you get descended into ridiculous. And when we can have a conversation and really figure out what that is, he says, oh, I'm a giant. How ridiculous. Why would I believe you? You're obviously not a giant.
So, oh, do not believe me. Never believe me. I never said that. I'm ridiculous.
So why would I believe?
Because the only thing that can give you the truth, and the truth is depressing.
I am a giant is not the truth. And the truth is not depressing. There's nothing depressing about what's depressing. Tell me the truth that's really depressing.
God, there is no God?
It doesn't depress me. You don't believe that there's a God.
Oh.
That doesn't depress me.
But there is no.
Oh, nothing.
It could be fun though.
What?
I mean, not for you, because you're great. I love you.
What? What are you talking about is fun? Not believing in anything? Believing all this just for nothing, and I just do whatever I want, it's just going to happen. No.
And that's why I don't like telling people like stuff like that. Because they always like, it's like, there's no God? Yeah, I can do anything? The first time I expressed this person, the first time. The third time I expressed this to somebody, I did it as a what if. And he was a very Christian person. He worked out all the time. He's a lot bigger than me. He was like one of my big workout brothers. He was like, Jack, I'm not super in shape, but he was like in shape. And I was like, oh yeah, who's those guys? Like, oh man, there's no God, dude. I swear. He's no God, I'd go back to where I was. I'd be fucking bitches, man. I'd be out there just fucking robbing, murdering. It's like, there is a God. And I found Jesus, and I'm glad I'm where I am right now. It's like, yes, you believe in God. You keep doing the shit you're doing. Good job, bro. And he's doing it now. He's doing great.
No, tell me someone that you're convinced that there wasn't one.
What? Oh, there's no one. Because I would never.
You just tried to, you literally just said, no, it's no one. I'm going to get you out of that. Like, and that was the most.
Oh, because I don't care about your happiness. Because you're smart.
Think about what you're saying.
He was not smart.
You're literally representing that opposite side. That's what I'm talking about. Here's a God, man of God saying all these positive things. Here's a man that's not of God saying, hey, fuck what you believe in. Be upset. Yeah. That's not, you know, that affects you more than it affects me.
No, it affects, yeah, fair.
That's fair. What I'm saying. That's what I'm
You can keep about. Believing in God, but I can't pretend, like you always ask.
You don't have to pretend. I don't care. I didn't ask you brought it up. You keep doing this capitalism is God. It's just a
capitalism is God.
Here we go again. It's just a money system. Money does not equate anything near to what God is.
Capitalism is our God.
It's a shame that, you know, that's telling me that you believe that. You get what I'm saying? Like, you believe that the highest systemic goal is money. And that does track right.
I can do it in three steps.
In every conversation, that's what you go back to. You get back to, oh, if it bleeds, it leads.
No, I can do it in three steps. Capitalism, God. So, during the pandemic, why did we shut down?
You want me to answer?
Yes.
Man, you gotta deal without me. I'm telling you, I'm gonna keep going back.
During the pandemic, why we shut down? The reason we shut down is because people were dying. So there's a lot of people dying. But stop.
There wasn't. They were saying that there was.
Yeah, but you already agreed there was.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did. I have you on camera. We can roll it back.
Yeah, we can. I didn't. I keep
you did. You 100% did. That's why I made
it. People die all the time.
Good sir.
I never.
Good sir.
What I'm saying.
Good sir.
I'm not a good sir. I'm a regular
good sir.
I'm just a sir.
Good sir.
Just a sir.
Good sir.
Just a sir.
Good sir. We can roll that back. We don't have to argue about it anymore. I already have no camera saying it.
Dude.
Good sir.
What did I say?
We can roll it back later.
No. That's what I said. Since you're so positive.
Next.
Go ahead.
During the pandemic, they were like, oh shit, ain't nobody making no more money. We need to get all y'all motherfuckers back to work.
What did they get from money?
Work? I don't know. Money? I don't know.
Food,
work?
Clothes, shelter. Anything else. Literally anything else. Just because that is the representative of the things we want does not mean that's our God. I want something past this dollar bear. I want this fucking $400. I want this laptop and this $400 can get me that. That's it. That's all it is. Out of thousands of years of humanity trying to figure out a system that we can use instead of just killing motherfuckers and doing all that other shit. All right, we said, work, I'll pay you some money, and you can buy ink. This is a universal barter ship.
So anyway, guys.
You can buy weed, you can buy vagina, you can buy
It's not a us concept. It's a miscommunication. I don't know how to express the concept that everything just costs money. Like, you can breathe air free, eat food free, trees grow, air grows. You should not pay for sex because it creates like a weird thing.
So how do we get anywhere? How do I get you to build me a house? How do I get Jose to fix my sink if I don't give him anything? This is all free. He just has to do it.
Curious, right?
I asked him. That's why you need a system like capitalism.
Yep, curious.
How do you get the Nintendo Switch? Somebody just says, here, you can have it. Here, I made these things for free using free labor. No, that's how you can't. It's just a way to communicate. It's just a way to get across the fact that, look, this is worth this. I will pay you this. That's it. Because I want it. I need it for my own whatever. I don't care what it is. I need a dog mask. I need some airport luggage. I just need what I need to get by. And I'm going to use this money, again, a universal system. Everywhere has money. Everywhere has money. Except for, like, tribes. And I'm not trying to go back to no loincloth that has, you know, civilization. Bro. I'm not trying to go out and hunt a panther every day not knowing I'm gonna make it, not knowing I'm gonna live, we can't even have this. We wouldn't even survive. We talk about fat people. They wouldn't survive. They wouldn't survive. We wouldn't be able to get to the point of people talking about there's no gender and you're fat phobe and all this other stuff if we didn't have money. Why? Because it's a system to where you don't have to be very smart. You don't have to agree with everybody or anything. But you can make a living. You can be okay. That's what I'm saying. You can make a living as a nihilist. What if it was all just religion-based? You didn't believe in God would kill you, which was a point in time.
Curious.
That's when they had gold, I'm assuming. And that was a very limited resource. It doesn't compute. It does not compute.
Yeah.
All right, I guess we got to end then.
Could we survive?
Could we? Is that what you're asking me? Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Not even really. I can't write. Can we survive our capitalism?
Hey guys, next week, can we survive our capitalism? That should be the topic. Can you survive our capitalism?
We can do that topic. We said we can touch on the God stuff again too if you want. It's just something.
I don't want you not to believe, dude. I love the fact you believe. I love it.
You openly say it. I can start with this, which makes you not a man. I'm gonna get you out of it. Which is strange. Like, get me out of what? My belief.
Being happy? Yeah.
Come on. No, what are you talking about? But that's all, man. And that would be the opposite. That would be the opposite I'm talking about. Which would prove that, or, I don't know what the opposite
is. Could we survive on capitalism?
I don't think so. Not everybody. Not the way we're surviving now. I'm telling you, fat people.
What would the world look like?
It would look like.
I'm running a futurism this year.
We're hunters and gatherers again. We're back to whatever we can forage and find, we will survive. If you can't, you will die. Oh, fuck it, this is in this episode. This is a lot of, we have to cut a lot of news. I'm going to see you the raw clip, but the first one, do an edit. If you feel like it, I'm going to do an edit. Because it's so, that's dense. These subjects are so dense. It was such on the opposite side. I'm sure it got
incoherent. Which makes it good.
It's great. But I'm sure we got incoherence in there. So it's like, let's see what we can, you know. Alright guys, we're gonna say peace. That was a heck of a mess. I don't know how fitness became that.